Okay, so this is the third part of the match photo tutorial. We have our basic massing in, and these are just the two photographs we're going to use. We're not going to go all the way around the building. But our goal now is to add in fenestration. So I'm going to go into our zone, and I'm going to draw using the photo as a guide. I can actually copy this window here and paste it around the corner because SketchUp likes to glue onto surfaces. The height is the same on this window, but it looks like it's not as tall. So I'm going to use the Move tool. I need to be careful when I'm moving that I'm moving on axis. So if I navigate away from here, now it looks like our typical EnergyPlus file. I'm just going to do, I may not do all the windows for this demonstration, but enough to see how to do it. So I'm going to look here. I'm going to go divide it by 6 to fill in the rest of the windows. You have to be a little careful using that in SketchUp, in the OpenStudio plugin, because if you do the wrong number and you try to undo it, it doesn't work well, and you have to manually delete them and redraw them. Still a very nice tool to have. Well, let's just draw a few more things out here. We're still inside our zone, or now we're back inside our zone. I'm going to draw this window. Do another one over here. Copy it and paste it over here. And I think that's enough for now. So that gets the windows in there. And you would continue doing that to the rest of them. Awning I'm going to add on as a shading group. So again, the origin doesn't have to be anywhere in particular, but I'm going to put it there. And I'm just going to draw a line here. I can actually come back and draw two horizontal lines to complete the shape, and then actually extrude it across over here. We don't actually have a bottom or a back edge here, so our awning is shaped like that. Okay, we just did the new window, the new awning. I'm going to copy this one over, making sure that I'm on the green axis, not the red axis. I picked a tough spot to choose that. And I'm going to select this back edge and use the Move tool and extrude that out, again, on axis, on green axis, rather. So if I look, it looks just like it should. I haven't done all the surfaces, but I think it's enough to show the idea. I'm going to move around to the back. You can see my surfaces line up like they should. We can go ahead and draw a few more in. So this is not too exciting to watch, so we're going to finish this up kind of quickly here. I'm going to copy, and then I can use, just like I did, divide it by 7, I can go times 2 here, although I should have done times 3. It looks like there's another window beyond there. Double click. I'm going to copy using that distance as a guide. That is really going to be, if I exit out of here, you can see the awnings. That's going to be the end of this tutorial. I'm going to do another quick tutorial after this that's going to show you how to take this model and break it into multiple thermal zones, which will be useful for photo match, but also for other activities outside of the photo match workflow.